Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can write algorithm to insert an item in linked list. So we will be discussing three algorithms. So first will be adding any item at the first position of the linked list. Second, adding any item at the last of the linked list. And third will be adding any element in between the linked list, like after a particular node. So we will be reading the position, like after which node we want to insert the element. So that we will do in this algorithm. So right now I am going to write first algorithm, that is for add first. So this is the name of algorithm. Then whatever terminology we are going to use that I am mentioning here. So these are the things that we are going to use in this algorithm. When you will be converting this algorithm into a program, so these terminology might change accordingly. So let's say if you are implementing this algorithm with C, so you will be using structure. If you are using C++, then you will be using classes. So accordingly, you will be passing the variables. So here, start will be the pointer for that will be holding the address of first node. So let me draw those as well. So let's say this is start. And initially it is null. Then info and link, these are two parts of node. So I already explained this while I explained how to write algorithm to traverse each node that are available in linked list. So if you have not watched that video previous to this, so you can find link of that video in the playlist. So that link is available in the description of this video. So you can follow that as well. Then we have avail. So avail you can consider as it is a pointer that holds base address of the free memory space. So we are considering these are the free memory blocks and these are linked together through some kind of addresses. And this first location's address is available here. So let's say this is 5001 and it is stored, right? And item is the value that we are going to insert into that node that we are going to create. So now I am going to write the steps so that you can understand how we can write algorithm to add a particular item at first position of the linked list. So step number one. So in case of step number one, I am checking overflow condition. So if avail equals to null. So avail is basically pointing to the free space. If there is no free space available in your system, so avail will be holding null value. And if avail is equals to null, it means you cannot allocate any value and you cannot insert any node into your linked list. So you can simply write print overflow and exit. So this thing you also need to verify while implementing this algorithm with any programming language, that you have enough amount of memory or free space so that you can allocate that memory to the linked list or not. So after this validation, I am writing step number two. So if step number first is false, then step number two will work. So step number two will do step number two will do, it will extract a memory block from this available memory space and it will be allocated to a new temporary point. So now I am writing rules. So set new equals to avail and avail equals to link of avail, right? So this statement that I have mentioned here In case of programming, this will be done automatically. Let's say if you are using malloc to allocate memory space, so this will happen again. But for reference purpose, in algorithm, we need to mention these lines like you need to show that we are extracting free space and we are going to allocate that to particular ledgers. So here you can see new is available. So I am creating one more pointer that is new. We are assigning avail to new. So avail is pointing to the base address of this free space. So that will be available here. Right, and if we write avail equals to length of avail, it means avail will be pointing to this location and new will be pointing to this location. So this block is now extracted from the free space and its base address is available with the new. And let's say address of this location is 6001, so it will be pointing to this. So now this is your free space and new is pointing to this location. And now what we need to do, we need to insert this location to this link list so that we can store that. So this way memory allocation internally happens. So I hope you understood this concept. So remember one thing also, physically you cannot move your memory location. You just need to store the addresses into different pointers so that you can say, like if I have or I am holding a particular address, it means I have write on that memory location. If any other pointer is holding that memory address, then that pointer is having write on the that memory location. So initially avail was holding 5001. So this memory allocation was under this avail pointer. But now new is holding this address 5001. So on this memory location, new is having the rights. Okay. Now moving further. So I am going to write step number 3. So in case of step number 3, I am writing set info of new equals to item. So whenever we extract this memory location and we assign base address into new, so you need to imagine that it is internally divided into two parts. So two parts means, so let me explain this here. So this is the memory location I'm drawing here. This is the first part, which is info, and this is the second part, which is link. So info will be containing the value or item, and link will be containing the address of next possible, right? So here we are assigning item into info of new. So info of new is this, and let's say item is 60. So 60 will be assigned here. 60 will be assigned here. Then step number 4. So this node will become the first node. This node will become the first node. So first node address always stores in this start. So right now I am writing link of new equals to start. So start is having null. So null will be stored into link of new. So link of new is this. So this location will be having null. And now we need to store this location to the start pointer. So you can write set start equals to new. So new is having 5001. Now this value will be stored here. And this link will be break. Or you can say this is a temporary memory or temporary pointer that we use to extract memory from available free space, and we assign that pointer into start, that is our actual address. So now you can see this pointer. So I am removing this line from here, and it is pointing to this, and it is pointing to this. So here you can see start is having 5001, and it is pointing to this first location. So this way we inserted a node into linked list at first position, right? So this happened when linked list was empty. Now linked list is having one node. So now we need to understand, like, if we want to insert one more node before this 60 value, so how that will be happening? So again, you need to execute this whole algorithm. So you need to check avail. If it is null, print overflow. So avail is not null because I mean, Then new equals to again. So again a temporary pointer will be created, that is new. This time it will be having value as 6001. Address of this available free space. And away will move to next location. So away will be moving to this location. And this location is pointed to this new. Right? And it is internally divided into two parts. So when you will be implementing this algorithm into C or C++. So remember that whenever you will be allocating memory space, so you need to create your structural class in such a way like two memory blocks will be there. One will be info, that is of int of loop type, and second will be of pointer that will be holding address of next node. Right? So this way we can say it is node number one. Now we are creating node number two. And we need to insert node number 2 before node 1. So now these statements will help. So this time item is 15. And we need to insert into info of new. So info of new is this. So 50 is stored here. Now link of new will be having start. So start is having 5001. So 5001 will go to new link of new. So link of new is this. So it will be having 5001, right? So it means 5000 went here and new will be assigned to start. So new is having 6001, so it will go here. So now what will happen? It is pointing to 6001, so this connection breaks. It is pointing to this and it already break. So this node is now first node and its next part is having 5001. So this is this node. So it is now. So now I am removing this available space so that you can easily understand this. So this start is pointing to this and this is pointing to this because its next part is having 5001, which is the base address of this. So this way I hope you understood. Like this node is now first node and this is second node and its next part is having. So this way add first happens. So with this algorithm, whenever you want to insert any node at first location of the linked list, so you can apply these steps. With the help of these steps, you can implement your function in C or C++ so that every time your node will be inserted to the first location. Right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can perform add first operation. Now I am going to explain the add last operation. So let me first erase these. So now I erase the statement. So we are going to study add last. So name of this will be add last and step number one will be same and this I am changing. So this is our first node 6001 and this is our second node. So I am arranging them properly so that you can understand that. So let's say this is first node 6001, this is second node 5001, it is having value 50, it is having address as 5001. Value 60 and this is connected with this and it is connected with this. And here we have away that is pointing to free spaces, right? And let's say it is now pointing to this 1001, right? And we need to insert this available space at the end of this linked list. Right, so we are going to perform a last operation and again here you can see same parameters are available. So start info link avail item then overflow condition. If avail is null then we can print overflow and exit. It is if we don't have any space then we cannot create a node and we cannot insert it into linked. Then we have step number 2. So step new equals to avail, then avail equals to link of array. So this way, a new pointer will be there. It will be holding address of this location. It will be expected, and let's say this is 2001. So I will be pointing to 2000. So now we need to insert this node at the end of this link, right? So now again there will be two cases. Like there may be chances your link list is empty, or there may be chances that the link list is having nodes. Those are already available. So we will see both the cases. So now step number three. So set info of new equals to item. So let's say this time I'm going to insert 40. So 40 will be stored here. 40 will be stored here. And we already know this node will be inserted at the last location. So it's link. It means this will always be having null value. So we can set that already. So set link of new as null. Right? So this new location is filled. Now we just need to place its base address at the end. So let's say if your link list is having two nodes. So after this node, this node will be coming. So 5000 once next or link will be having base address as 1001. So that through 5001 we can move to 1001. Right? And if your link list is blank, or start is having null, so we can just assign this new to start there. So step number five, if start is equals to null, it means your link list is blank and we are inserting first node only. So you can write set start equals to new. So in that case, whatever address is available in the new will be copied to start, and this node will be inserted to the link. So I hope now you can imagine this. So this is the first case. Second case, if you have a node already available in the link list, so that case is already available here. So in that case, you need to write else, and inside else, you need to repeat a loop so that you can move to the last location. So I am writing set PTR equals to start. So we are using one more pointer so that we can move to the last location. Now I am writing repeat. So we need to repeat some set of steps while. So now we need to figure out the condition. So condition will be link of PTR not equals to null. So link of PTR not equals to none. So now PTR is having start. Start is this. So PTR is pointing to this location 6001. Now check link of PTR. So link of PTR is 5001, which is not equals to none. It means we can move PTR to next location. So here you can write set PTR equals to link of PTR. So link of PTR is 5001, that will be stored into PTR. So PTR will point to this location. Now again you need to check the condition of loop. Link of PTR is not equal to null. So this time link of PTR is null. So this loop will not repeat now. Okay, so you can write for reference and not loop. And after completion of this loop, PTR will be pointing to the last node. So now what you need to do, you need to assign this address to this location. So this is link of PTR. So link of PTR equals to new. So this will be the next step. So in this else, after completion of this loop, you can write set link of PTR equals to new. So new is having 1001, that will go to link of PTR. So here
it will be having 1000. So it means now this is connected with this, and this is having next as. So this way we inserted a node at the end of link list. Now here you can write end of if. So this step number 5 is completed here, and step number 6 you can write end. So this way, this is second algorithm that is for adding a node at the end of the single link list. So now I am going to erase these. So now I need to explain this one, add after. So I am changing this to add after, and here one more parameter is required, that is position, like after which node we want to insert one more node. And let's say I am erasing this, and I am writing this here. It is having 40 and null, so it is pointing to this. This is 2000, this is 3000. So this is our available free space. So now let's say position is 2. Position is 2, it means after the second node, I want to insert one more node. So new node will be inserted in between 16 and 40. So between 16 and 40, I want to insert one more value. So for that, I'm going to write this algorithm, that is add after. So step number 1, set PTR equals to start. So PTR will be pointing to this first location, right? Now I'm going to repeat a loop. So repeat steps for I equals to 1, 2, position minus 1. So position is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So this loop will repeat one time right now. So PTR is already on this position. So if we repeat one time this loop, so PTR will move to this position, right? So here I am writing set PTR equals to link of PTR. So link of PTR, so PTR is basically pointing to this location, and on this location link is having 5001 that will be assigned to PTR. So PTR basically now points to this location, that is 5001, and this loop will be terminated. And if you have, let's say, 50 nodes and your position is 20, so loop will repeat that number of time, and on 20th node it will stop, right? So this way we process this, and now we can check if PTR equals to null. So it also happened, it can happen. Like you are rotating the locations. So let's say position is 20 and you have only 3 nodes. So whenever you will be iterating this loop, so at end PTR will be having null. So if PTR is having null, it means you entered the wrong position. So here you can write node position does not exist and exit. So this you need to check also, and here you can write end of loop. So step number 2, first loop will be iterating, and then the set condition will be checking this, and if it is true, then this will be printed, right? So here you can write end of if. Okay, then step number 3. So here we need to check the overview condition. So if avail equals to null, So if available empty space is not there, if available is null, so you can print. Overflow and exit. Right? Now, fourth step, if available memory space is there, then set new equals to avail and avail equals to link of avail. So again, there will be new. It will be having address as 2001 and avail will be pointing to 3001. It means this new is pointing to this location. Now this location is not under the control of available keys. So it is reserved and now we need to transfer this address in between this, right? So I hope you understood till step number 4. Now I am writing step number 5, set info of new equals to item. So whatever value is available in this item, let's say it is having 20. So this 20 will go to info of new. So info of new is this part. So it will be having 20. Right? Now what we need to do, we need to store this address 2001. To link of PDR and whatever is available to link of PDR, we need to store that here. Because when we insert this 20 in between 60, 40, so after 20, we have 40. So its base address is 1001. That should come here. So what we can do, first we need to store this address that is available into link of PDR to link of new. Right? Because if we store this address first, then 1001 will be erased. So we need to store that first. So step number 6 will be set link of p, sorry, link of new equals to link of PDR. So link of PDR is 1001. It will be assigned to link of new. So link of new will be pointing to 1001. So now this node is pointing to this location, right? And we need to remove this 1000 from here and we need to store 2000 so that after 60 we can go to 20 and then we can go to 40. So for that we need to write step number 7 and here we can write set link of PTR equals to new. Right, so new is having 2001, that will go to link of PTR. So link of PTR is this position, so it will be now 2001. So if I remove this PTR from here, so what will happen? 6000 location next or link is having 5001, it will move to this, it is having 2001, so it is disconnected from here and it will move here. Because this location's base address is 2001 and its link part is having 1001, so from here we can move. So this way you can see without moving values, we have inserted one node in between the links. So this is error. So this way I hope you understood all the algorithms, all three algorithms for add first, add last and add after. And we can also convert all these algorithms with the specific programming language. So you can convert them, convert these algorithms with C, C++, Java or any other programming language. So if you want to watch like how we can write functions based on these algorithms with the help of C language. So I also created those videos. So you can go to description of this video. You will find links of playlists like ESA using C. So you can watch those videos so that you can understand how actually in programming language we can implement these algorithms. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching.